Hey y'all, welcome to What Chelsea Eats. Thank you so much for joining me today. I am going to show you how to make this beautiful, colorful soup. And it was so good. It was so hearty and filling. And it's perfect for a cool day, a summer day, a spring day. Like, you can have this anytime you want. And what I liked most about this is that it made my stomach feel full. And a lot of you are always looking for something to make your stomach feel full. It will make your stomach feel full, but yet it is light and it won't weigh you down and bloat you out. So if you'd like to see how I make this soup, stay tuned.
Okay, ladies, I'm gonna make a quick meal for my family. This is fibroid friendly, or else I wouldn't be showing it to you. Here is some kidney beans, low sodium organic kidney beans. And no, I do not always use 100% organic. I just happen to see these in the store. The pickings on the shelf are low at my local Target, so this is what they had available. Then I've got some diced tomatoes. Then I've got a half of a red pepper. I've got two zucchinis that I'm gonna chop. And then I've got one onion. I'm gonna use the whole onion. And then I have a small box of baby spinach that I'm just gonna stir into the dish at the end. Now, for the seasonings, I have some chopped onion flakes, some pink Himalayan crystal salt, some curry powder, and some garlic powder. Of course, I will write the exact ingredients that I use in the description box of this video, but this is something that could be done in less than 10 minutes, literally. I don't spend a lot of time chopping the vegetables very small. I just stick it in a pot, heat it through, and serve it. So, if you're saying you don't have a lot of time to cook and you want to have something that's yummy, try this recipe. Okay, ladies, here is the cooking process. As you can see, I have put a little bit of water in the pan down here. And we're just putting a little bit of water in there so we can saute our vegetables. Everybody's always asking me, how do you cook without oil? This is how you cook without oil. You can use vegetable broth, you can use juice, carrot juice, tomato juice, celery juice. Whatever kind of juice you have on hand or vegetable broth that you have on hand, that you can use it. But most of the time I use water so I can season it the way I want. So first I'm going to add the red pepper and onion. And as you can see, I rough chopped this. I didn't chop it fine. You can do whatever you want. I actually like the texture of rough chopping the vegetables, so that's why they're so big. So we're gonna just let that heat through and saute that. I'm gonna try to do this in real time and not edit, so you can see how long it actually takes to make this dish. Turning up the heat. I mean, it took me, I can say it took me about 3 minutes to chop these vegetables, maybe less. Because I just chopped an onion and I chopped a half of a red pepper. If you don't like red pepper, you can use green pepper, yellow pepper. You can leave the peppers out and just choose another vegetable altogether. So I'm not gonna wait until these get soft. If that is your preference, you can do that, but I happen to like crunchy vegetables in my soup because I just don't like to cook them to death. So the next thing I'm gonna add is my chopped zucchini. You can use whatever you want. This is what I had in my refrigerator. You can use yellow squash. You can use, what else can you use? I mean, just any vegetable you have on hand, you can use. And so if the water in the pot cooks down, all you have to do is add more water. At this point, I don't feel like I need more water, so I'm not gonna add more water. So before I put the beans in, just gonna let that cook a little bit. I'm gonna add some salt. So I'm just gonna measure this with my hand. This is about between a half and a teaspoon of salt. If I need more salt, I'll put it in there. Next, I'm gonna add some curry powder, and I'm gonna add about a tablespoon of curry, because I want it to taste like curry powder. You can put less, or you can add more, and after I taste it, I may even add more. So the next thing I'm gonna add is garlic powder. Y'all know I love garlic powder. I'm gonna put about a tablespoon of garlic in there. Sometimes I'll add more, and if I had some fresh garlic, I would have added that too. Not in addition to, but I would have added it as, I mean, not instead of, but in addition to. So I'm gonna put about a tablespoon, maybe two tablespoons of dried onion flakes. And now I'm going to stir. Let those vegetables get coated with those seasonings, and it smells good. If you notice, I haven't had to add any more water because the vegetables are sweating down, and the zucchini actually has lots of water in it, and so it's kind of releasing the water from itself to add to the cooking of this dish. Okay, so next what I'm gonna add is the diced tomatoes. These are fire roasted tomatoes. You can use whatever you want, or you can leave the tomatoes out altogether. Also, this dish is probably gonna serve about 3 to 4 people, depending on how big your portions are. You could also serve it over quinoa. Not brown rice. Y'all know how I feel about grains. They don't mix well with fibroids, especially if you have symptoms. So this is the first can of kidney beans. And this is can number 2. Smells so good. And just stir it around. Ooh, it smells good. Let that heat through for a second, and I'm gonna get my spinach ready to stir in. So I'm opening the package here of organic spinach. The thing I want to start happening though is for this to bubble a little bit. All right, heat through. I hear it bubbling. There we go. You see those bubbles over there? That's what I want to start happening. All right, and I'm gonna add my spinach. I just added a whole package of spinach. And if you can hear, it's bubbling. So what I'm gonna do is just press that spinach down into the soup. And as we get this stirred in, it's gonna wilt down. I'm gonna add a little more water because this soup is a little bit too thick for my liking. Add a little more water. You may have to adjust the seasonings if you add too much water. Okay, ladies, my camera cut off because my phone got hot, so I couldn't show you the end. But this is what it looks like. It is very, very delicious. But what I do think, if you like spicy food, like hot spicy, add some spicy seasonings to it. I'm going to add some chili peppers to it at the end. So I'm getting ready to serve it. See how good it looks? Oh, goodness. Yep, nice. Look how good that looks.
So ladies, there you have it. A hearty soup that's gonna put some heaviness in your belly if that's what you're looking for. I hope you liked this video. If you did, please give it a thumbs up, share it with a friend, and don't forget to subscribe. Until next time, y'all, take care. Much love.